Kwani, how long does it take before uniga ishe? Okay, so kwetu uniga ni how long does it take? Kama mlika mjoi akiwa mdogo, but bado uko na hiyo swag ya Chicago. Eh, manzi.
Si ako na Chicago.
Bro, ni kuwatch TV, bro. Calligraphy yake ilitoka wapi? My friend, my very good friend.
Yeah. But unajua ya calligraph ni second hand. Wewe ulikuwa nayo like ile ya from
second hand. But honestly, I guess ni foundation. Ni vitu, like mi kuna time nikianza kuongea na mtu ametoka states ama amesoma hizi ma group of schools. Yes. Kizungu yangu change kidogo.
Ah, yeah, unapata.
Imagine.
Na kutoka hizo. That's true. Yes, yeah. Mm-hmm. Ah. Same for me as well.
Na, how's inaitwaje HD from your eyes. So unaongea hivyo unaongea na mimi. So HD aki grow up, right? What is your perspective of him? Because yeye nikimuuliza atajidescribe differently. Mm-hmm. What kind of a brother was he? Wachana na loving. Like eh hey, niaje kuna zingine uko naangalia na eh mzee pia wacha.
No, he was a bad kid.
Kuna shuka kuti.
No, he knows. He's told this story many times before, but he was that. Can I tell the chicken story?
Yo, tell it.
He used to get like punished so hard because he was mtoto mjeuri. I don't even know how to say that in English. But he would be tied, like my mom would tie him under the dining room table sometimes as punishment. There's another time.
Mkono na mguu.
Sijui alikuwa anafungiwaje. Sometimes anapelekwa kwa chicken coop. Uh-huh. He's tied in there as punishment. Like his punishments were crazy because he was a crazy kid. He was very rebellious.
And that's why till date niko na phobia kuku.
For real?
Siwezi shika kuku, bro.
Oh, that's why you don't have a chick. So the worst punishment tuliyofanyiwa ni kuyakuwa kwa nyumba ya kuku.
Yeah.
That's the worst thing.
It traumatized me. Muku mpaka leo yani acha kucheka wewe.
Na wewe uzisosi?
Eh?
Wewe kula kuku.
Mbaya mura wa kuku. Lakini
HD's kitchen.
HD's kitchen na kuku Sundays.
Mimi
napenda kula kuku lakini siwezi shika kuku iko alive.
Hawezi shika kuku iko alive. But sasa madhe yako alidiscoverje that this would work on you.
Trial and error.
Akujua.
Na ukiekwa kwa kuku una change.
Nili change. Ilinishtua.
Na ukisema bad kid inamaanisha what was he doing to warrant him kuwekwa kwa company of chicken?
No, he was just rebellious. He was just those kids who don't follow, you know, the rules. He made his own rules in life.
Na mulikuwa mnachapwa na kitu the same because you mentioned a bit. Na najuanga kuna balance ya watoima boys na watoima dame. Mm. Different. Mulikuwa mnachapwa na the same?
I think so.
Yeah, tu ilikuwa mimi sana sana mwiko, na lakini na wengine belt.
Si unajua tulikuwa na wish za chapwa na mwiko growing up by the way.
Mulikuwa mnachapwa na?
Si blada ya nini? Inaitwaje? Taya. Itaya. Time. Si ouch. Kuna...
Oh, no.
Kuna time, in fact, me and my brother, we were caned so much that we hatched a plan to rehearse to boost our immunity for pain during beatings. So, nalala chini ya naniweka, mpaka tuzoe. So, nalala chini ya naniweka, naniweka, tuna practice uchungu, ananiweka, naniweka, alafu, tuluko napigwa kumi. When my mom used to be formal with beatings, unalala chini, unapewa kumi zako, unaenda. But before you get to the number 10, ilikuwa long. So we decided to practice 10 strokes each.
Wow.
It did not work, as in it was too much.
Na mlikuwa mnafikiria sana. Kids are very intelligent. Yani mlikuwa mnafikiria hiyo yote. Kupractice, ndio mdevelop vaccine.
Mara ya kwanza.
Umenikumbusha kitu. You remember the way we used to play? Because dad alikuwa sema tusicheze kwa bed juu itaharibika. Hana pesa ya kununua. But sasa hiyo game inatubamba sana. So tunacheza, alafu tulikuwa tumejua ni belt cha chapa nayo. So tunaweka kale ka kitambaa. Kuna ka belt kengine ka kitambaa.
Oh yeah, we would put the light one.
Yeah, the light one. Tunaweka hapo kwa mlango in case
akawa.
Hapa kitu chapa tuna...
No, wait. Ni makosa yenu ilikuwa kuruka kwa bed?
Eh. Ni makosa... Ya uniga.
Makosa yako. Okay, what was the biggest crime ulifanya growing up?
I mean, I was a good kid, so not much. Probably just similar things like he's saying, maybe jumping on the bed or stuff like that, but not
jumping on the bed.
Wait, you remember makosa ingine kwa nyumba ilikuwa nini? What we couldn't do is talk English.
Ah, that's true. No, I didn't know we got punished for it though.
We used to be pinched
for talking in English.
So what happened? When my mom and dad came back to came to Kenya once, and we were not born, so it was only my big sister Eunice and my brother Mumu. They traveled to Kitui, to our ancestral home, where my dad was born. And then my dad was embarrassed that
they couldn't communicate with our grandmother.
Yeah. So he vowed that these kids have to learn Kikamba by fire, by force. So when we went back, like tukazaliwa, sasa tulirudi huko, akatoa amri kwa nyumba, we have to talk Kikamba ndani ya nyumba. Yeah. So anytime we talk English in the house, we're chuno.
For real?
Yeah. That's how we know Kikamba.
Yeah. I always say my Kamba is excellent. It's much better than my Swa.
So nini watu mumepiga Kikamba na accent ya Chicago?
Or no, we talk Kikamba.
We
came from the US winging. We're like, you remember when Grace was asked how come Mumu didn't come to school?
It was
today?
Me.
It was you?
Yeah.
Let me say that story.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Yeah, she got a shot.
So I got sick and went to the hospital, so I didn't show up to school for a day. And then now, when my sister was asked, like, oh, what happened? How's Joey or whatever? She was like, she got a shot. And then they're like, she got shot.
She got a shot.
She got a shot. She like, got I a got shot. An injection.
Like for an really? Injection, like a shot.
Na hii ni Katoloni primary school. Yeah. Which primary school are we talking about?
Uko ingine hapo.
Ya mashinani.
Yeah.
Karibu uko macha ndani.
Mulitoka Chicago, mukaingia uko.
Straight. Culture shock. Tulikuwa naitwa mzungu. I say, as brother, nimekuwa mdark saizi. Nimechomwa na jua huku hii. Ya Nairobi. Hey, bro, tulikuwa light skin. Tulikuwa na Joey lighter.
But we used to get picked on a lot.
Mm. So we were talking
fluent English. Now we don't know Swa. First of all, we have to learn Swa.
We only knew Jambo.
Scratch.
Jambo.
Nyinyi mulikuja mkisalimia watu Jambo.
Jambo, yeah.
But the Jambo Jabos of Machagos.
Jambo Jambo. Jambo Jambo. Tulikuwa tunaongea fluent English, wenging vizuri, na fluent Kikamba.
Oh, my
friend, you know, the school is as you are not. And they were the school woman, they were at an apple. But Kiswahili to Jambo.
Ah, manze. Na, did you get to a point mkaanza kumiss your life ya US, kukaa huku?
I think I did. I think I struggled quite a bit just trying to acclimate to this life. I remember I was just running away from schools. So I was
running away from school.
Yeah, actually, maybe that's the worst thing I've ever
done. Don't say I'm only a good girl.
Yeah, I mean, listen, I didn't want to be in these shower schools, so I would run away. There's one, I faked a sickness and I just went home and I never came back. I was sick into another school. I was there for like a week, ran away again. Like, I would just, like, I was like, this is not my life. I don't know this. I am not this person. I deserve better.
And that's,
so I campaigned to get myself in a much better
school.
And
that's how she found herself in an American system school.
Oh, for
being paid for fees times 25, my fees.
There's a time you calculate. I think like your parents may be too hard on you, but I guess it matches the punishment that you guys used to get. Ati kuchapwa na belt. Sisi a belt wa vile nimesema belt. We used to admire watoi wanachapwa na slippers belt na wanachunwa.
Because
si tulikuwa tunapromisiwa like a beating. Even our mom knew that you had to be psychologically prepared for what's coming.
Right.
So alikuwa anatuambia you have to alikuwa anakuambia akipata tukicheza huko anakuambia write somewhere down. Anakuambia andika mahali that leo jioni tunaenda kumeet. So na wewe unajua what the message means. Na wewe unajua mkiingia chemba it's serious. It's a full session. Ikona ni organized.
Wow.
As in, it's a ceremony. CRT, si surprise, CRT, na ni makosa kubwa, ni makosa. Mean kisikia ati kuruka kwa kitanda. Zin, what do you mean bad kid? Ati umefungwa kwa mguu ya.
Watu wako na shida different in life, bro. Watu wako na shida different. Wacha nikuuliza swali, juu natuuliza swali mingi. Do you support corporal punishment?
Corporal punishment?
It's good question.
I don't, in this sense. Looking at me as being me. Because there was a time I told my mom that you don't have to beat me, right? For me to, ndio mimi nisikie what you want me not to do or to do. Najua? We can just talk. I think I've never, I always have this feeling that I've not changed internally. Labda I've grown physically, but reasoning yangu nikiwa class 8, I didn't deserve a beating to get an understanding and to understand what I need to do. Plus, maybe someone should have had my reason for doing what I did.
Okay.
Because it later affected me because of the amount of beatings we received.
Yeah.
In high school, I had problems that I could have just talked to my parents about, like we're sorted, but based on the fear of being clobbered, maget, it ended up piling up ikwe.
That's right.
Na makosa, makosa kubwa. Kuna time nilihepa home, nikasema naenda Mombasa mguu. Nilivunja thermos, nikasema sasa si mi naenda Mombasa. So nika walk from Embu Town, nikafika place inaitwa Defathers. Defathers is not very far from Embu Town. So I decided to take a break. Nilikuwa na 20 bucks, so I felt that that was enough. Unajua, growing up, nilikuwa nikikula ngumu moja na sikia niko sawa. So na 20 bob, nilikuwa na jembe, hizi ni ngumu zinaweza ni last. So, juu niliuliza mtu, jokingly, kutoka hapo mpaka Mombasa, unaweza take how many days? Akaniambia 3 days. So si nikapiga. So day one, nikafika Defathers. I made new friends. New friends at hapo kwa Kasenta. Alafu, it was a very lonely thing that kufika jioni, kila mtu anaenda kwao. And then I remembered, oh Lord, oh, I need a place to sleep. So I started walking back.
Back.
To look for a place to sleep in familiar grounds so that I can start the journey again.
Again. Take two
the next day. So I went back. Nikafika Embu around 7. It was raining. So what happened is I couldn't go sleep at anybody's place. Nikaenda kwa kibanda. Kwa kibanda down. So ilikuwa kibanda ya cabbage. Alafu, they had like a door, ya awa mamamboga. I think hapo ndio uweka change. Nikaingia hapo.